This is Mission Control Houston. Welcome and thank you for joining us for today's edition of Space Station Live. It's been a busy week of scientific research, maintenance, and preparation for the goings and comings of visiting cargo ships, as well as an upcoming spacewalk at the International Space Station for the Expedition 36 crew members. Flight engineers Karen Nyberg and Chris Cassidy and Luca Parmitano got together Monday to talk to public school students from Douglas, Massachusetts. And all six Expedition 36 crew members have performed an emergency drill on Monday. The onboard training allows the crew to practice communication and coordination skills during a simulated emergency scenario. Chris Cassidy had worked on a science hardware inside the fluids integrated rack. He then configured hardware for the advanced colloids experiment. While Nyberg had removed a depressurization hose in the Tranquility node's urine processing assembly, and Parmitano replaced a urine receptacle and filter inside Tranquility's waste and hygiene. Then on Tuesday, a trash-filled Progress 51 resupply craft undocked from the aft end port of the Zvezda service module. A Progress 51 had delivered 3.1 tons of food, fuel, and equipment for the station crew on April 26. It had launched 2 days earlier from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan. However, after reaching orbit, one of its antennas for the Kurs automated rendezvous system did not deploy. As the Progress cargo craft had departed, the ship's external cameras were focused on navigational sensors on the Zvezda docking port. Imagery was gathered to confirm that the sensors were not damaged when the Progress arrived at the station with one of its navigational antennas folded against its side. These sensors are required for a new cargo ship, the automated transfer vehicle, to dock properly. Also on Tuesday, flight engineers Nyberg and Cassidy had set up samples for the advanced colloid experiment, which observes microscopic solids that are suspended in a liquid. Results from that research could benefit the manufacturing of smart materials for spacecraft and improved household products on Earth. Then Nyberg had performed a periodic fitness evaluation measuring her bone and heart health on an exercise bicycle. Cassidy had also worked with tiny bowling ball size satellites, also known as spheres, which allows students to test their programming skills. The six-member Expedition 36 crew then took a break on Wednesday with an off-duty day in observance of Russia Day, when the country declared its sovereignty in 1990. Europe's fourth automated transfer vehicle, the Albert Einstein, had continued its trek to the International Space Station for a June 15 docking. That's this Saturday. Two rendezvous burns were scheduled on Wednesday to refine its path to the station, where it will dock to the Zvezda service module's aft docking port. Flight engineer Parmitano had assisted Cassidy, who hopped on an exercise bike and had his blood pressure monitored for a fitness evaluation. And Nyberg had monitored her blood pressure as part of a periodic medical exam and collected her saliva sample for stowage in a science freezer. Meanwhile, on Wednesday, Commander Pavel Vinogradov had worked with the ongoing Russian experiment known as Plasma Crystal. The study records plasma crystal forming processes and parameters such as gas pressure, high-frequency radiated power, and the size of dust particles. Flight engineers Alexander Masurkin and Luca Parmitano had spent Thursday morning practicing the rendezvous procedures and abort scenarios for the ATV-4 cargo craft. Ground controllers had reviewed the imagery of the Zvezda docking port for that possible damage to reflectors that could prevent Saturday's docking of the Albert Einstein. Meanwhile, flight engineer Karen Nyberg had worked with an ongoing fluids physics experiment known as capillary flow experiment. Also on Thursday, Cassidy took photographs of samples collected for the binary colloidal alloy test experiment, known as BCAT. BCAT studies the effects of microscopic solids that are suspended in a liquid that could benefit materials fabrication processes here on Earth. And on the Russian side of the house on Thursday, Commander Pavel Vinogradov and Masurkin had partnered together for more work with the plasma crystal experiment. Vinogradov had also checked the Russian laptop computers and reconfigured communications gear. And Masurkin, along with Fyodor Yurchikhin, the two spacewalkers, worked together to gather more tools and equipment in preparation for the June 24th spacewalk. Friday is an off-duty day for the U.S. crew members of Expedition 36, since the trio flight engineers Cassidy, Parmitano, and Nyberg will be working over the weekend to support the docking of the Automated Transfer Vehicle 4 resupply ship. Flight engineers Yurchikhin and Misurkin are preparing their Orlan spacesuits and tools for their six-hour spacewalk that'll occur just outside the pier's docking compartment on June 24th. During their six-hour excursion, the two spacewalkers will replace a fluid flow valve on Zarya, deploy and retrieve experiments from the Russian segment modules, as well as string power cables along Zarya for the eventual arrival of the new multipurpose laboratory module that is scheduled to launch at the end of the year on a Russian Proton rocket. The crew is scheduled to go to bed at 4:30 p.m. Central Time. This is Mission Control Houston.